What's up, Internet? This is Random Game Critic, and welcome back to Spyro the Dragon. Last time, we made it through, I got distracted by all these screwed up enemies. But last time, we made it through Haunted Towers and got definitely the hardest dragon in the game to get. And now, welcome to the boss stage. This is, I think it's pronounced Jacques, but I don't really know for sure, because I don't speak French. But regardless, the return of really, really drugged up enemies. You saw like those monkeys with the metal armor, I don't know what's up with that. As well as these guys that have these giant flowers. But here's one thing interesting about this level. Right off the bat, there are split paths. And not only are there split paths, but on this path, there's a split path on the split path. You can go two different ways from here also. Okay, here's the way this is going to work. I'm going to go down one path, then cut to back here to the second path then. That's how I'm going to do it. Yeah, alright. I'll start by going right, I guess, because the left way is not the right way this time. I can't stop saying that now. The reason I say that so much, like, you guys probably don't even know what that is anymore. For those of you who don't watch my games very much or don't remember what the big deal about that saying is, it was in The Legend of Spyro, Dawn of the Dragon, my first LP with Super Yoshi, and at some point, like, I'm like, well, let's go left, and he says, no, we'll go right. No, I wanted to go right, he wanted to go left, and he says, but the left way is the right way, and it stuck with me ever since he said that. Well, mostly because what he said after that, I can't think properly. After he said the left way is the right way, I said, okay, so left is right and right is left, and he said, no, left is right and right's wrong. That's what stuck with me, because that was like the stupidest thing I've ever heard anybody say, and it was so funny. So that's why I keep saying that now, because I remember it because every time like we watch that video, Nate like facepalms at what he said there. Because it is kind of silly, yes, and it was funny though. So yeah. That's the origin of that saying, in case you guys didn't know, because I keep saying that now. I keep saying the left way is the right way without any context as to what I'm talking about. I should probably have gone the left way first, because there's a chest there that I need a key to get to, as well as, is this the boss? It is, yeah. Well, we'll do that in a minute, but now that we've gone all the way this way, I'm not sure, should I actually, like, totally... Okay, this is the other path, which... Okay, so I'm at the end of one path now, so as promised, I'm gonna go back to the start of that area again, real quick, hang on a second. Oh, I should probably get those first. Now we'll see you guys in a second. Wow, that didn't take long at all. I'm not even gonna add that out, screw it. Now you get back here, you fool. That's better, alright now. Hang on a sec. Okay, now I remember. I'll go to that path later. But there's two paths on this path, literally. Like, there's a path and then a path, you know, a Pathception or Yo Dog, take your pick. Getting mildly sick of the Inception jokes, though, although Inception was an awesome movie. I don't watch movies very often at all, really, I don't. Like, there's a whole bunch of classic movies that I haven't seen yet, which is kind of pathetic, but... I'm not a big movie guy, but I did watch Inception, and I freaking loved it. It's a movie that was... Not only was it fun to watch, a lot of action, it made you think, though. There's a lot of heavy psychology involved in that movie. And I took a psychology class in high school, so I actually was kind of all over it. They're talking about dreams and how there's a whole bunch of different effects to it. Like, one point they made is that for some reason, whenever you're in a dream, whenever you die, it wakes you up. And they bring that up also. And they also talk about, what else do they talk about? Whatever. Inception is an awesome movie. End of story. One up. And also, now that I got that key, I can open up this chest now. Right? I can. I totally can. Okay, good. Now, there's one more thing I gotta do in this stage. I'm not even gonna bother cutting, because it's a very short walk back, actually. It takes longer to go through the path, because you gotta jump up all this stuff and kill everything. Going back is easy, though. Now, I remember earlier I killed this thief, and then... On this path here, it actually does literally... Oh my god! I gotta, like, calm the hell down here. And not just that, but wake the hell up. So that thief does nothing in this path, but it actually does something in this path over here, though. So you gotta hit both these guys. The one I just hit raises that. The one I hit a while ago lowers this one. So now I can actually get over here and rescue... This is the only boss that has two dragons. So let's see what he has to say for us, because I'm sure he said something other than thank you for releasing me. Excuse me.
Thank you for releasing
me. Are you serious? Come on. Every time I expect him to say something else, he says that. What the hell? Well, that's just awesome. Well, there's more to this area... There's a split path within a split path within a split path now. Excellent. Okay, well, this is easy, though. I remember during Ratchet 5's LP this game, because a while ago... what the hell, I can talk about him, because... a very long time ago, none of you guys know this anymore because I actually deleted all these, but a long time ago, I created this channel just to make reviews of video games because I reviewed the first two Legend of Spyro games out of complete and total boredom. And back then, like, well, I deleted them all since then because I moved on to Let's Playing now. And the reviews weren't that good anyway, so. But way back when, I reviewed the first two Legend of Spyro games, but it started when I reviewed Kirby's Epic Yarn, actually, out of complete and total boredom. And my first subscriber, who wasn't a friend of mine, was named Ratchet5. And since he was my first subscriber, I checked his channel out, and he does LPs also. So I watched him for a while, and it was kind of cool, actually. But recently, a while ago, he unsubscribed to me, and he was actually kind of boring to watch, so as soon as I found out, oh, he unsubbed to me, I immediately stopped watching him, because he was boring, and I just watched him because he's a subscriber for me, and we actually came to be kind of friends also. Took me forever to connect to him on Skype, but when I finally did, nothing happened anyway. He's kind of a boring guy also. I'm not like bashing him or anything, but really, whatever. But the reason I brought him up though is because I remember he did an LP of the Japanese version of Spyro the Dragon, and he's with a bunch of friends also, and they were trying to find differences, and right here there's a difference. There was like one of these four pillars was missing, and since there wasn't any difference in the first two versions, because early on in the game there's a lot of differences between the American version and the Japanese version. But at that point, it was like the first difference in a very long time, so they all went like, oh my god, there's a difference! There's a difference! And they all freaked out over like one missing column, and I remember that because it was funny, actually. I just remember that because it was a funny moment of their LP. Another funny thing was when they went through the last stage of the game, the finale, like one of their friends was just talking about random shit, and Andrew was getting so pissed off. It was actually, it was funny. I should check him out, maybe, because I haven't seen what he's up to in a long time. Last time I watched him, he was playing Croc 2. You know, do you remember Croc? Back on the PlayStation 1, he's playing that last I checked, but enough about him, let's get some advice for the battle.
Any advice before this battle?
Advice? A wise dragon once told me, aim high in life, but watch out for flying boxes.
Huh?
To this day, that is the greatest video game quote ever. Aim high in life, but watch out for flying boxes! This is Jacques. In case you couldn't tell, literally, you just chase him. You can't even hit him yet, actually. Now you hit him, once he gets on top of the present box thing. Aw, man, I love that line, though. Aim high and light up, watch out for flying box. Because I remember looking at comments and, like, the music for this stage. Because that's what nerds do when they get extremely bored. They look up the music for games, look at the comments, see what people say. And one of the comments, I think it was actually the top comment, said, it pointed to that quote, aim high and light up, watch out for flying boxes. And then he said, oh my god! What the hell? Can I survive? I can. Well, that was unusual! So yeah, the guy I was looking at comments. The guy said, he pointed to the quote and said, "What the hell?" Yeah, that's totally what happened. Oh, that was so strange. But he said like, "Aim high in life, watch out for flying boxes." And then after that, he said, "That is going to be my yearbook quote at the end of my senior year." That'll be like his. Oh shit. Okay, let's try that again now. But yeah, he said that'll be his senior yearbook quote. You know, where people talk about advice in life. Like, for my senior yearbook, all I see is a bunch of Bob Marley quotes because he has, like, really, really interesting things to say. They're all Bob Marley quotes because he is, like, the ultimate hippie. Like, he says a lot of drugged-up things, which do make sense when you think about it, but... Eh, it's weird. But that's what the guy says yearbook quote's gonna be. Aim high in life, watch out for flying boxes. I would love it if he actually did that. That'd be hilarious. But anyways, I just killed Jacques there and didn't even care. Another 100 gems there. As well as 25 gems, I believe, that I'm missing. Which are right up here. No, 75 gems. And that should do it now, right? Okay, so next time on Spyro the Dragon, we are going to... Now that I just gave that really bizarre story, next time on Spyro the Dragon, this is actually the last episode before the finale. We're almost done with this game, actually. So next time on Spyro the Dragon, we are going to Icy Flight. I'll see you guys there.